a young priest was set for preaching for the first time in a particular parish. The theme that this priest had chosen that day for preaching was revival in Christian life. As soon as the priest began his preaching, he was able to attract the attention of the people, the audience. This was not only because of his eloquence in preaching, not only because of the depth in his reflection, and not only because of the conviction that he had while preaching, but it was also because of a small mispronunciation. The theme of the preaching was revival in Christian life. But because of the small speech impediment of the priest, it was heard as revival in Christian life. Well, the audience, the people, did not really mind that, because that was also a strong and relevant message being sent across. Yes, revival in Christian life begins with a re-Bible experience of life. Do you want to have a revival in your Christian life? Then I invite you to pick up your Bibles and to have a greater conversation with our God who reveals his love in the Bible, the Word of God. One of the most beautiful hymns that is known to many of us is this: the more I hear of the Word of God, the better I will know him. Yes, this hymn tells us the beautiful fact, as mentioned even in the very first verse of the Catechism of the Catholic Church, where it says, God invites every human being to know him and to love him. The more we read and understand God's word, the better we can know him. And the more we know him, the better we can love him. And the more we love him, the better we can serve him. God invites each of us to understand God's word more and more, and thus to know him, to love him, and to serve him better. One of the most popular verses of the Bible, which I'm sure all of us know by heart, is the Gospel of St. John, chapter 3, verse 16. Shall we all say that verse together? For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. God sent his Son, the Word who became flesh, John 1:14. And this Son, this Word, can be encountered and experienced in the Bible, God's Word, God's love letter to each one of us. We know that very often life takes us through the deserts of struggles. There are moments when we are badly hit by the storms of problems in life. In all those moments of difficulties and despair, God invites us to pick up our Bibles and to experience his love that is revealed through the pages of the Bible. We know even in this time, when the world is going through a lot of struggle and suffering, we have many questions. Questions of uncertainty. Questions, perhaps, even of hopelessness. To all these questions, God invites you and me to pick up our Bibles and to experience his love enshrined in the Word of God. The beautiful story is told of a young pilot who was flying the plane. Being inexperienced, once his plane went through a space of turbulence. Because he was inexperienced, there was a lot of panic and fear that filled his heart and his mind. From the control tower, this young pilot was able to hear a lot of sounds, instructions being given. But because of the inexperience, the tension that filled his mind and heart, the young pilot was not really able to give heed to those instructions. Finally, after some time of struggle, this young pilot would hear a strong and stern voice coming from the control tower. And the voice went thus. Listen to me, young man. I am the chief of the air traffic control. And I want you to listen to me. And the man, the young pilot, began to hear this voice more closely. And the voice went on to say, if you take care of my instructions, I will take care of your obstructions. If you take care of my instructions, I will take care of your obstructions. God invites all of us to understand that in the Bible, He gives us instructions for our life. When life takes us through turbulent moments, listen to the instructions given by our chief controller of our life, and He will help us to lead the plane of our life to safety. As beautifully said, Bible could be expanded as basic instructions before leaving earth. You take care of my instructions, and I will take care of your obstructions, says our God. Today, I invite all of you, dear brothers and sisters, to pick up your Bibles and to make reading the Word of God a daily practice in your personal and in your family life. There could be perhaps many of us who have tried to read the Bible entirely. If you have done, great, shall we try it once again. But if some of us have not done that, read the entire Bible once, can we try to do that? Individually as well as the family. It may happen perhaps that sometimes some of us may feel there are certain passages in the Bible which are not very clearly understood. Some passages even disturbing and not that very interesting. But let's begin to understand that the Word of God was written in a context which is very much historical. The Bible, especially the Old Testament, greatly reflects the customs, the traditions, and the practices in and around, particularly of the nation Israel. And so when we read the Word of God, let's not get disturbed by those dimensions. Rather, let's understand God has a purpose in giving us His Word to us. To this effect, one beautiful method of reading and understand the Word of God, especially the Old Testament, is what is called as the typological method of reading. Typology. Reading the Old Testament in the light of the New Testament. The Old Testament was written so that the people of Israel will be prepared to receive Jesus Christ, the Messiah. Therefore, typology is an invitation to read the Old Testament in the light of the New Testament, in the person of Jesus Christ. I give a simple example. The 22nd chapter of the book of Genesis speaks about the sacrifice of Isaac. Abraham taking his beloved Isaac for sacrifice. As they are on their way, Isaac would ask a question to Abraham. Genesis 22:7. Here are the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for the sacrifice? When we read the sentence in the light of the New Testament, we understand who is the beloved, Jesus Christ. Who was the lamb to be sacrificed? Jesus, the Lamb of God. This beautiful method of typology invites us to understand the Word of God deeper and more meaningfully in our life. I invite you, therefore, all of you, to pick up your Bibles and to read the Word of God, meditate, understand, and make God's Word a beautiful aspect of your daily life. God invites you to know Him, to love Him, and to serve Him better. And the more you read God's Word, the more you can do that. Yes, no Bible, no God. Let's begin to grow more and more God's Word, and thus become powerful witnesses of Christ in the world. May God bless all of you, and may we always live Jesus.